I'm being joined today by Richard Cross, a movie critic, author, music critic, and writer. I mean, there's all sorts of things I guess we can use to describe you.
Well, and former CKBW employee.
Well, I was going to get to that. Yes, you were going to be at the Astor Theater in a couple of weeks' time, and we want to talk about that. But I did notice that you keep that on your bio.
Well, yeah. I mean, my first job to me was very important, and it really was the place that set me off on the path that I have followed my whole adult life. I grew up listening to the radio station, and I got a job there when I was young. I was 15 or 16 years old, and somehow managed to convince them to let me on the air, which they did. And I wasn't very good, I don't think, but I lasted a little while down there on the air. But I remember walking in there for the first time and going into the newsroom. And there was something about just the sort of excitement of being there, of looking through the big glass windows that used to be there. I don't know whether they still are, to look through into the studios and seeing all the people that I'd grown up listening to actually making radio in the moment, right there. I could see them live. And it hooked me, and literally hooked me for life.
It is terribly addictive to get into this business, isn't it?
Well, it sure is. I mean, since then, I've worked at a lot of other radio stations. I worked at CBC Radio. Right now, I'm on a station called News Talk 1010, which is the oldest continuously running radio station in Canada. It was for many years known as CFRB. And I still get the same little charge out of it every time I walk into a studio.
Now, you went from spinning records in the evening to becoming a critic and a writer, and I guess really the writing part was what drew you away from here and on to Toronto, correct?
Yeah, it was difficult to make a living down there doing the things that I wanted to do. I wanted to write about music and film, and there just weren't enough opportunities for me down there then. Now, it might be different now because the internet has changed everything. And now I would start a blog. Now I would be able to write and have more people see what I was writing about. But at the time, really the only place for me to be was in Toronto. And I moved there a long time ago. I was about 17 years old then. And I got writing gigs fairly quickly, although, you know, none that you were getting paid for. I wasn't getting the right writing gigs. I guess that's what I should say. I wasn't getting the ones that were helping me pay my rent. But I managed to put together a portfolio, and in those days, you actually used to see writers going into interviews to, you know, meet with editors or whatever, and we'd bring, you know, press clippings and things. Now it's just all done online. But at the time, you had, literally a portfolio that you would spread out on the desk and say, this is what I did. And I knew that it was important for me to build one of those up. So I just came up here, and I wrote for whoever would publish me. And so I wrote about music. I remember there was a time in Toronto, and they're all gone now, but there were pinball arcades everywhere. And so I wrote a long story where I went around and hung around in pinball arcades until all hours of the night and met some really interesting characters who were like, you know, semi-professional pinball players, which you don't meet many of in the run of a day. But they were really fascinating characters, and I wrote a story about that. I wrote literally about anything that I could just to get my name in print.
Now, one of the things, of course, we see you pop up doing these days a lot is movie critic, as in your role as that on Canada AM and on various other television shows, and you pop up doing that. And that's kind of what is bringing you back home. The Astor Theater has recently converted from their old 35mm projector to a new digital projector, and it's kind of the reopening of the cinema part of the theater that you're going to be taking part in coming up on May 24th.
Yeah, I began to hear about this a couple of years ago, I think, that they were getting money together to revamp all the stuff. I mean, who knows how old the projector that was there before was. And technology is changing so quickly, and everything's turning digital. I'd heard that they were going to get this fancy new projector, and I thought, well, wouldn't it be fun to do something down there for this? So they got in touch with me. I got in touch with them. We went back and forth. And when all the equipment was in place and that sort of thing, we were able to hammer down a date, which is May 24th. And we're going to go down and we're going to have a lot of fun. That is a theater that's enormously important to me. Like walking into CKBW for the first time, when I walked into the Astor Theater for the first time, And I was probably, to be honest, carried into the Astor Theater for the first time because I'm sure I was probably a baby or close to it. My parents would have taken me there. But when I remember going there, when I remember being able to get there under my own steam, I just fell in love with movies sitting in that theater. And it didn't matter what it was, whether it was Enter the Dragon with Bruce Lee, which they seemed to play an awful lot down there, or, you know, the Poseidon Adventure, where I remember one of the great shots that is burned into my memory from years ago was sitting in that theater and watching The Life and Times of Judge Roy Bean with Paul Newman. And in it, there's a sequence where someone gets shot and there's with a shotgun, and there's a big hole in their stomach, and the camera pans down and shoots part of the scene through the hole in their stomach before the body falls over. And that has stayed with me for 40 years, probably, that scene. And I saw that at the Astor Theater and so many others. And so when the opportunity came up to go down there and actually spend some time down there and be on that stage again and help them sort of kick things off, there was no way I could say no.
Now let's talk about the evening itself. You you have a couple of shorts that you're going to bring with you to play before the movie, which is something you don't see a whole lot of these days, but you found a couple of interesting ones from Nova Scotia that you'd like to show people.
Absolutely. I was reading about the history of the Astor Theater. It was built in 1902, and it's been open pretty much continuously since then. And in the 30s, 40s, and 50s, they would play newsreels and short features before the features. So I thought it might be kind of fun to do that for this night as well that we're throwing. So I found two great short films produced by Bravo Fact, which is an extension of Bell Media, who give out loads of money every year to short filmmakers all over the country to make movies. I found two great ones by two Nova Scotia filmmakers, and I'm not going to tell you too much about them, but I will tell you that one is called Sex with Hot Robots. If that doesn't make you want to buy a ticket, I don't know what will.
Now, the main feature for the evening is The Disappeared.
Yeah. Yeah, this is exciting to see this movie. I've seen it here. I hosted the Toronto premiere of The Disappeared a few months ago, and now it's on its way to DVD. It's a feature film about six men who are lost at sea, and it was actually shot just in the waters off Nova Scotia. And that's why I think it's kind of exciting to see this movie that is a homegrown film, a really beautiful, well-made, great homegrown film on a screen down there. And, chances are good if you, have lived in Nova Scotia a long time, you'll know someone that worked on the film, or certainly the actors will be familiar to you. So it'll be a really fun thing to do. And this movie has won awards all over the place. It's a really good film, and I think people down there will really relate to it. I know that coming from there, I certainly did.
Now, I understand you might even have a couple of people who are able to get by and chat about the making of the film as well.
Yeah, we have some of the actors coming through, Neil Matheson, Gary LeVere, and Brian Downey, and actually also the cinematographer of the film is coming in, a guy called Chris Porter. And I'm interested to talk about how this movie was made, because it was actually made on the water. And anything that you're shooting outside of a studio is extremely difficult, and particularly when you're dealing with the unpredictable nature of the water, the weather, and everything else, there were a lot of challenges involved in actually making this movie. So we're going to talk with that about the guys after everyone has seen the film.
So that sounds like a pretty complete evening all in itself. You got a couple of good shorts, you got this movie that is made locally, and a couple of the actors dropping by to chat about it. And then we're going to throw in on top of that a little music from David Miles in the evening. He's going to be dropping by as well.
Oh, this is going to be a really fun night, and something, a little bit unusual. I'm not really thinking of it as just going to the movies. This isn't just a usual buy a ticket, sit down, watch a movie, eat some popcorn, and go home. This is going to be a party to relaunch a movie theater that should be, a legend down there. It should be one of the staples of your movie-going life, because it's such a beautiful theater. It has such great history to it. And, you know, right now, or, you know, as of May 24th, when we do all this, it will have stepped into the digital age, and you will see and hear films in the Astor Theater in Liverpool in a way that you've never seen or heard them in that space before.
And we should mention that the name of the overall show will be Setting the Stage for the Digital Age. And tickets are available at the Astor box office. You can go online at astortheater.ns.ca or call the box office at 354-5250. And it should be a really great night. Richard, it just seems like all kinds of great stuff is going to be happening that evening.
Yeah, I'm hoping that it's a kind of an unpredictable night. I'm hoping that not only do we have a lot of fun with the films and the music and everything, but I want to get people involved as well. I want them to ask questions. I want them to tell me stories about growing up and going to the Astor Theater. For me, it was such a huge part of my life.
I can remember a few films there myself, actually, to be quite honest with you. So.
Absolutely. And I think that, you know, if you have any memories of them, you know, let me know on the 24th. I'd be more than happy to hear about them.
Richard, thank you very much. We look forward to seeing you on May 24th at the Astor Theater.
I'm looking forward to it. See you, John. Thank you.